I'm about to cut one of these really pretty olive wood blanks. This is the Bethlehem olive wood before. This is going to be a Virtuoso pen. Working on several pens at the same time. Made myself a little cheat stick here so I know exactly or close to where to measure it from. Always try to drill it a little bit longer. You can always cut more off, but you can't put more on it. So make my mark here. I'm going to use my stick. Cut on the outside of the line so it's always long enough. This is the middle of the Virtuoso pen. So you see I've got about an 1/8 inch on each end. I'm about to cut this piece of olive wood for the Virtuoso pen. Alright, I'm about to drill one of these really long olive wood pen blanks we cut a few minutes ago. This is the Virtuoso pen. My drill press is very short throated. The length of that 3/8 inch bit is a lot longer, so I can't use my table until I get it about halfway through. This blank should be long enough to take out of the press. And there's your 3/8 inch hole all the way through that piece of wood. We have to rough the edges, the brass tube, so they have something to adhere to inside that hole in the wood. So let's start off with this. Ready to glue the tube inside the Virtuoso pen. Anybody that tells you one drop of super glue is enough, hold up a man from a helmet, they line. Wipe the excess glue off. That'll have to sit for a little bit for the glue to have a chance to completely adhere. Use a little stick fast activator. Make sure that it sticks to the tube. The glue's had a chance to dry. Now we're going to go ahead and square the ends of this one off. Squaring off the other end of the tube. If you'll look, you can see where the end of the tube right there is now even with the end of the blank. Every pin that we turn requires a different set of bushings for the size of the pin. This is the bushing for the Virtuoso pin. About to put it on the lathe here in just a minute and see if we can get it knocked down from this block down to a beautiful olive wood pin. Alright, this is the olive wood we've chosen for the Virtuoso pen. It's going to be a really pretty satin silver pen when we finish. Got to start her up. It's in a square form right now. It's going to be really beating you pretty good. right, we've got it out of the square, Faye. That is an absolutely beautiful piece of wood. Beautiful grains. Got it rounded. Now we just got to get it down to the size of the bushings to meet the size of the ink pen. So here we go. Noise at the end is vibration when he's not supported as much as it is on this side. Right there. I gotta make sure the ends are even here. This is where the pen meets the material, right there and there. I gotta make sure it's smooth, doesn't have any ridges, humps, bad spots in the wood, so it'll have to stabilize. It looks pretty good so far. Really pretty piece of wood. After doing a couple of thousand of these, you get a feel for it. Feels really nice all the way down. I'm just a little high on the end right here. So it's going to meet the cap where the clip is. A little spot right there. Beautiful piece of wood. Color of butter inside some of it. When you turn the olive wood, you can actually smell olives. Crazy as that sounds. Now we're going to move the tool rest out of the way. We're going to start with sandpaper. This is 100 grit. This is an Evernet sandpaper, I believe they call this. Doesn't let the grit, the sandpaper, doesn't clog up or it won't sand anymore. Let's sand this until it stops creating a wood dust. We're up to our next 240 grit. Same thing. Sand pretty much until there's no dust. That's a 320 grit sandpaper. You notice the higher grit you go, the less dust you get. Because the wood is smoothed off. Pores in the wood are closing up. This is a 400 grit. Go to a 600 grit sandpaper. Trying to stay my clothes out of the way of the lathe. Then we'll stop and look it over. Then we'll sand it long ways to make sure that all the grain is smooth all the way around the pin. Beautiful piece of wood. Here comes the next part. This is a polish time. This is a polish I'm about to apply here. It has a walnut oil shellac and a carnauba wax, kind of liquid. I'm going to put about 4 coats of this polish on. The lathe is spinning at about the same speed it was while it was turning, about 4,000 RPM. Between every coat, we'll give it a second or two to dry. You see how shiny as it is already. I'm in with a second coat. Shiny, shiny. Remember now your wood is sanded to 600 grit, which is much higher than a lot of furniture quality of sanded. There's 2 coats. There's my 3rd coat. Let that air dry for a couple seconds. And the 4th and final coat. More coats you put on, up to 4. Look at the finish. I'm gonna let that dry just a second. Use a cleaner part of the cloth to buff it off. Once again, the lathe is spinning at about 3,975 RPM. You can tell from looking at my clothes exactly where the pieces went. The lathe is off. That is absolutely beautiful. This is the pin kit. The way it comes, the way I get it. I'm going to take this pin kit and assemble it according to the pieces laid out. This will have to be widened or loosened. Clip should go here, I believe. I'm going to press this piece into place. This is the transmission at the end of this piece here. It turns the pin when you turn it. This piece is going to screw onto the end here. This piece is going to push inside, make sure that's tight. This piece is going to push inside. Doesn't require a lot of force for this piece to go in. It's almost longer than my pin press, this whole thing. My piece unscrews. This is where the refill and the spring go. And there's the pin. This is the reason I make pins right here. It's hard for me to believe that I can come down in my garage and in about 30 minutes I can take something like this and turn it into that. That is a writing instrument I would be proud to have for a long time.